Hey everyone, hope you've been doing well. This is a video I've been looking forward to making for a while. It's a big topic and I think a lot of people get really worked up over it for some reason. And that's just the simple idea of whether or not to include a direct box on your rig with the HX Stomp. This video is part of a series where I'm building a full pedal board around this thing. And I just want to share my experience on why I've chosen to build one permanently into my pedal board and why it might either be a good decision or something that's not very worthwhile, depending on your own situation. There's a lot of wrong information out there, and unfortunately a lot of really well-known individuals in the guitar modeling Helix world that don't understand the topic very well, so I'm hoping that this video can just end that discussion and hopefully it can serve the purpose of educating anyone who is looking to try and make this decision. If you've been following the series, you would have seen the direct box that I decided upon. This is the Pinstripe Pedals DISO Plus. It stands for Dual Isolation. And technically, it's a stereo box, by the way. Technically, it's better defined as a line isolator and not a direct box. We'll get into that in a second, where the difference lies and why a line isolator is actually what you want. Now, the first thing we need to address is that if you're an HX Stomp user, you're probably aware that the chassis here on the output jacks, it actually says balanced or unbalanced. Line 6 has given us the option to be able to use a standard TS unbalanced connection or a TRS balanced connection with the HX Stomp. Both will work fine in a lot of different situations, but I think it's worthwhile to understand what happens when we create a balanced signal. There's two things that happen. Number one is called impedance balancing. This is where we take a high impedance signal and convert it into a low impedance signal. It improves the signal to noise ratio a little bit, and on a TRS connection, we end up with the same impedance on the tip and the ring. The sleeve is just the common ground here. The second thing that happens in an ideally balanced connection is that we actually take the signal that's present on the tip and we phase invert it with the transformer and send it to the ring. What happens here is that we actually end up with two versions of the same signal traveling out of phase down a cable. By the end of the connection, we're going to perform another phase inversion so that they're put back into phase, and any signal, any extra noise or interference that cable would have picked up along the 100 plus feet that it's traveling to the front of house system has now been canceled out. So although the HX Stomp does perform impedance balancing, it does not have differential output. To include two transformers in this thing probably would have increased the size of it and definitely the price. So although it would have been an upgrade for sure, I don't think it would have made a huge difference to a lot of people. So let's talk about the situation that you might be in. Do you need a direct box? The answer is probably no, unless you're touring and playing a lot of different venues all the time. If you're someone that's playing the same three or four venues and you've never had an issue before, it's probably not worth the money. The obvious answer to connecting your HX Stomp to a front of house system through a stage box, then a snake, is just to get a TRS to XLR cable. You can get two of them so you can run it in stereo easily. That's the great thing about modeling. And that'll work a lot of the time. However, if you ever run into a situation where you're getting a ground loop, you're gonna need a direct box. This will lead us to a brief discussion on direct boxes versus line isolators. A line isolator is essentially made to work with guitar modelers that are already outputting a low impedance signal. So a direct box, like I said, does two things. It takes the high impedance signal, converts it to low impedance, and then it also provides that differential output. It does the phase flip and, you know, can send a truly balanced connection down the line. A guitar modeler such as the HX Stomp is already putting out a low impedance signal. So to take that and put it into a normal direct box, drop down the impedance again, is gonna mean that you're losing about 15 to 20 decibels of signal. And this is quite obviously a problem because of our signal to noise ratio. You're just gonna probably end up with a little bit more noise at the end of the chain because you have to boost it with a preamp. So what we can do is take a line isolator, which is already designed to accept a low impedance signal. And what this does is then just simply provide the phase inversion, the differential output. It's better than a normal direct box in that sense. Of course, you could just set this to line level and send it into a normal direct box if that's already what you have. I don't see any real issue with that. It's kind of like using a flathead screwdriver to work on a Phillips head screw. It'll work, but it's not quite the right tool for the job. Another thing I thought worth mentioning as a benefit of having direct box is that transformers inherently block direct current. So if your sound guy hits that 48 volt phantom power button, it's not gonna ruin your tone. In fact, there have been some instances I've heard of phantom power kind of crippling and damaging a Helix product. Line 6 has stated this is not supposed to be happening, but I've read about it, and it's just nice to know that that's never going to be an issue for you. So there was a brief lesson on why a balanced signal is important. I also want to provide a little bit of context here, because as I said earlier, it's probably not necessary for everyone. If you've never had an issue using a TRS to XLR cable, man, just stick with that. Don't waste your money on something that you probably won't have a benefit for. However, if you are someone that's playing a lot of different venues, eventually you're going to run into an issue where there's a difference in power between the stage and the front of house system, and that can reveal itself in a ground connection issue where a ground lift switch is going to be a really great thing to have. So I play with a lot of different artists. If I'm backing up a more well-known singer, I'm probably in a mid-sized to a smaller club venue where they've got plenty of high-quality DI boxes and stuff available. Even still, if I run into a ground loop issue, I don't want to be the one holding up that sound check. I'm just a sideman. I really don't want to have that kind of weight on my shoulders. So I just want to be prepared for every situation, and having a direct box on my own board ready to go at a moment's notice is worth it to me. There was one situation at a smaller jazz club. I was playing with my original group, a well-known jazz club in Philadelphia. If you're local to that area, you probably know what I'm talking about. But I always run a stereo rig, which is a weird thing I know for a jazz musician to say. So I showed up to this venue, and for some reason there was a block party going on nearby, and I was stuck in traffic for something like 45 minutes. So I got to the venue like with 15 minutes to go before the sound check. I ran my stuff in, set it up, went and parked my car. I did have a guitar amp in my car, luckily. But when I came back, we started the set, and I realized that I was only hearing the wet effects out of the monitor. And here's what happened. We ended up having to use two different direct boxes for my stereo signal, and one of those direct boxes ended up phase inverting the sound. And I had never experienced this in a live situation before. Despite what a lot of people say, most professional front of house systems are stereo, in my experience anyway. So it was sounding fine in the house, and I'm kind of mentioning, you know, trying to get the sound guy's attention, like this is not sounding right. And what was happening was that the monitors were summing to mono, and my dry signal was phase canceling itself. However, the wet effects were coming through. So I was telling them to boost the guitar level. I couldn't hear myself, and then I hit a chord and just this reverb would just shatter everyone on stage. We had to cut the set short. I just ran to my car. It was raining. It was like two blocks away, not fun. Ran back with my guitar amp and just plugged in, finished the night like that. At the end of the gig, I was talking with the sound guy and we realized that we had an issue of phase cancellation. I never want that to happen again. So for me, spending the money on a direct box to have on my board permanently was a great decision. To close this video, I just want to talk briefly about the DISO and why this is the product I decided to go with. It's got stereo inputs, stereo outputs. You can actually sum to mono with this if you're using a single onstage monitor like the Line 6 Power Cab. And then it also obviously has stereo XLR outputs with a ground lift switch on it. They do have an option for a stereo summing switch for the XLR if that's something you need. So this is not exactly cheap. It doesn't aim to be budget friendly. However, I thought it was worth it. It's equipped with Jensen transformers, all of the labors performed in the United States, the research and design, the circuit board printing, the drilling and painting of the enclosure, and the hand-wired circuitry, all performed by American labor. And so it's not exactly cheap. It comes in at $250. A lot of that price is caused just by the fact that it's using the Jensens. If you don't have that high of a budget for something, you could also consider the mono version called the MISO. Same exact thing, just mono, one less Jensen transformer. It comes in at $150. If you're looking for an alternative, I really don't have one for you. Something similar might be the Radial JDI, which also uses Jensen transformers in it. It's stereo. However, it's a standard direct box, like I mentioned earlier, not a line isolator. So if you're using a modeling rig that already outputs low impedance, you're going to need a line isolator. So to wrap it up, for me, it just comes down to reliability. I want my rig to be perfect and adaptable for any situation. I want it to be flexible, consistent, and just something that I don't have to think about. And if this gets me there, it's worth the money. It's not trying to be budget friendly. This is the Corvette of direct boxes, line isolators, whatever, and that's kind of reflected in the price. But here it is. There's the video. There's my honest thoughts on it. I'm really not trying to sell you anything. However, I will be sending this video to the guys at Pinstripe, so if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I can respond, or maybe they will respond and answer some of your questions directly. There are a lot of Helix and HX Stomp tutorials, free presets and walkthroughs and stuff on this channel. If you're interested in that, stay tuned for that. Maybe hit the subscribe button. And if you're interested in checking out the full video series that this video is a part of, where I'm building a full rig around the HX Stomp, I'll leave a link in the description to the playlist and also up here if I remember. I usually forget though. Anyway, take care. See you in the next video.